And welcome everybody here to the Pro National Cup here, the Pro Dota Cup. We have Team Germany against the FinStack here, Stark Esports, you can call them many, many names. And with me today is @LairGG. We're gonna do it all today. We have a best of three here. This is the lower bracket. The loser of this will be eliminated. So there's some on the line here for the both of the teams.
Yeah, let's hope Germany can do it. Radiant team back. I heavily root for them, of course.
If you weren't, you would be a bit of a traitor, I guess, you know, having your German heritage and stuff.
Well, let's see. If I see the draft, it's gonna be interesting. I mean, Germany takes out Shadow Fiend. I mean, pretty obvious, you don't want to give away a Shadow Fiend to the Radiant side. And the famous Larder offlane nowadays also gets taken out. And the Queen of Pain.
With these bans, also the Queen of Pain IO, it means that Doom plus Alchemist is still in there.
And there we go.
Dazzle here. Are we gonna see like an Husker now straight away, or will they go just for Tuskok?
Pretty standard draft. I mean, if Doom is in the pool, people are gonna first pick it nowadays. And of course, Dazzle Tuskok's response is also pretty common.
I just checked out, the new buff hasn't been, or the new buff, the new patch hasn't been gone into it, so there is still, of course, the big, Scorch Surface hasn't been nerfed, so you still have the, like, 45 healing per second at max level, so it's a bit troublesome there, but yeah.
Yeah, at least they took away the OP Aghanim Scepter, which literally, literally could kill anything, just had to Doom it, and that's it.
In the patch was also the Scorched Earth that was it, and I haven't, and Scorched Earth hasn't been, you know, adjusted yet, so has the patch actually come in?
Yeah,
I think it
got applied during Nanyang Championship, but it was not live, and immediately after the championship was done, the patch went live, so
hasn't affected the Doom pick right though. He has been picked up every time they can, and Team Germany even pick up the AA right now. Get out one of the counters.
It could be a deny pick, and it could also strongly indicate that they deny it and they're gonna pick up the Alchemist for themselves.
Yeah, at the moment there's nothing that really stops them from doing that.
Exactly. I mean, Slaughter is out, the Doom is taken, and if you pair Doom with Alchemist, I mean, you have super tanky frontliners, and Tusk and Dazzle don't provide any DPS. So, a really good pickup here.
Yeah, that would mean that Stark has to be start looking at something else then. And for mid laners, and again, like Doom and Hulk, you prefer to get like something that gives minus armor. And the first thing that comes to mind then is a TA, but you can't pick a TA against a Doom on mid. That like that's not gonna work. You're gonna lose the lane horribly.
Also, Alchemist does fairly well against TA because Acid Spray simply removes Refraction. So.
Yeah. So that's something to look at as well, like for Team Germany, I would say get out some strong mid laners if the actual thing is going to be a... I like Wraith King as well, like the reincarnation with Doom, it's just annoying. But still, like, if you get out these little bit of the hardest mid heroes that are left in the pool, like Ok can go mid quite easily here.
Yep. SF and Quap are fairly good against Ok and they're out, so...
I guess Windranger, if she can, she can abuse her, range a bit, but still, there's like no kill potential at all.
Yeah.
It's hard to deal with if they pick it up, but yeah, we're all just theory crafting about a possible Alchemist pick. Like, nothing is for sure here, so.
Oh, they take out the Bounty Hunter, that's interesting. Didn't expect that.
At Dusk, I guess, with the Dusk and stuff, it's hard to deal with.
It allows greedy lanes. If you take out the Bounty Hunter, you can really go for a greedy mid and have like AA doing her stuff, just pulling, getting level 6.
Yeah, just be lane support, I guess.
Yeah, can't really punish it.
If you try to punish it, you have Chilling Touch that you have to fight in, and in the early game that's not something you can do. Like, that will result in at least one counter kill. Doesn't even matter what the hell is next to it. FinStack, they have to be looking at what are they gonna ban now, like... You gotta want to ban the Lich as well.
They're not sure.
I guess the Lich is not possible.
Yeah.
I don't think Germany will pick up Lich, so never mind on that, sir.
Winter Wyvern. Also pretty decent. Okay, here comes the Dark Seer. This fairly well against AI on lane.
Yeah, AI doesn't really have a way to stop her and the creeps.
Exactly. He can just do his Dark Seer thingy, run around, Iron Shell, have some fun.
What I'm then looking at is, what would I pick up? Like, a CM? I would say a CM always works because you can get the creep out, but then you have a CM on your team. Which is not something fun to play against the slows and the surge.
Like, Finstack heavily lacks DPS at the moment. Like, none of the heroes do any damage, basically.
Like, that's the problem.
Okay, here's the bench.
Okay, so minus armor coming out of the side from the Germany day. It's also a good medallion carrier, so that helps Doom out a bit. Does mean that both the supports are not taken by Team Germany and Finstack. Yeah, they pick up the Wind Ranger, as I said about
before. Yeah, that's just...
Then that makes the Winter Wyvern ban also really logical. Just having that, you know, once you try to focus fire someone, just have Cold Embrace and it's kinda all gone. But still, this is all single, like this is a single target at best that they have. Like they have some AoE, but nothing from that can really kill someone. And once they focus on one or two people, they're kind of out of options to do anything.
Yeah, also they have no follow-up for the vacuum ball.
Just Snowball, maybe with shards could work out. Power Shield does also some damage. Weave, not really, because it needs to take down, so that needs more time. Also, who are you gonna catch? Like, Vengeful and AA are just gonna be in the back lines. Doom is gonna be in the front, so you get Doom plus one, maybe. And even then, yeah. That's not something you want. It opens up way too much for them.
They still have their mid laner open. A 10. That they will go for TA. Thinks it's lost TA.
10 seconds Zeus. Remaining.
Oh, it's a Zeus. Okay, so, global strat coming out with back. Zeus ultimate and AA blast.
So I think we should probably see a Clockwork Man now. It would be logical when they went for Spectre. Okay, there's also a strong global dire hero. I can see that.
They could still go for Prophet offlane and just safe land the Doom.
That's true, but yeah, against the Dark, I always have like second thoughts about putting any melee core against a Darkseer.
Doom does fairly well against Darkseer. He has so much sustain with his Scorch Earth, and you pair it with an AA and Venge, they just rotate in once, and the Darkseer is gone.
Essentially, yeah, you have Devour as well, of course, that comes off cooldown. Like, after the first initial creep is gonna be a big one out of the jungle. I guess against Darkseer, you kinda wanna get Unholy Aura from the Troll.
Something like that.
Or the Seder, I mean, Troll.
Anything works, actually, because if you get some stun or the clap from the Ursa, or the crit from the Wolf, I mean, it's damage to kill the Darkseer with the support. You can't stay there.
The only thing you don't need is the armor, actually.
Yeah.
Like, that's the one thing that's not really reliable or useful in that lane. But it might also be a Zeus offlane, like, that's something that has been shown before.
Let's see what carry they're going for. I mean, they could still go for PL.
But do you want to do that? Because AA's... once you get hit by the AA blast, it always shows which one the real one is. So
yeah,
dooming
also
it is easy.
Does fairly well, but... Yeah.
Lycan.
That's really smart. Yeah, they can't really contest them. Yeah, they have a pretty strong lane.
Good thing is, once he is transformed into, well, his ultimate, then dooming him doesn't really matter too much.
Exactly. Doom won't stop him.
Does mean that you need to get your ultimate off before going into the fight, not in the middle. That might be troublesome. That said, yeah, he feels also fairly squishy. They do have some ways to stop him, but if you have your team following,
but they
have
no heavy lockdown. I mean, it was a really smart pick here. Like, AA can't stop a Lycan, Doom can't stop Lycan, Zeus can't stop Lycan. The only thing they can do is stun him once with the Venge, and that's it.
Yeah, they can only force him to retreat. That's the essential part of it.
Ricky.
What?
Ricky.
Okay.
Okay. Is that an offlane Ricky? That's a carry. That's a carry Ricky.
He played LGD International, right?
I don't think so.
I don't know, it had his name, so like, what? But okay, yeah, that's it.
That's an offlane Doom. And carried Ricky. Well.
Well, guys, make sure to still put in your bets here to get the G2A gift card here. And good luck. I hope you selected the correct team, because this is these are two drafts that you don't really see with the last two picks, at least. Those are really uncommon.
I mean, I can see the tactic from Team Germany. I mean, they just give Ricky some space. He does fairly well against Darkseer because of his HP regen, which got heavily buffed this patch. So he can sustain against Iron Shell. The supports can do whatever they want. And when Ricky hits a decent level, he can just roam around and AA blast plus Usult, and anything is dead.
Yeah, it goes well with the global, yeah. You can have him scout it out, and having Zeus on your own team means that they don't really have that easy lightning bolt to use with that.
And for Finstack, well...
Germany being cheeky, oh my god. Putting out the Ricky emoticons.
Yeah.
Oh my god. I don't know what crap I did to get those, but...
I think it's from the last internet... International 2014.
Okay, so TF4.
Yeah, TF4.
Well, anyhow, let's just do a quick introduction here of the teams for the Finstack, aka Starks Esports. We have Okja on the desk already, keeping Oxia. Is he in stand-in?
No, I think.
Well, it doesn't matter. He's playing the Dazzle. For mid, we have Nemphy playing the Windranger. We have Boogie on the Lycan. The Leafs, Felix on the Tusk. And on the top lane here, we have Trixie on his Darkseer.
For Team Germany, we have a moment on the Ancient Apparition, Fohu on Zeus, Luft on the Doombringer, Xynxis on the Ricky, and Cube on Venture Spirit. And we already see a smoke, and they're gonna catch Windrunner.
She has to run away right now, but oh, she gets middle in this over stun. That is not well timed at all. She's gonna fall here one way or the other. It will take some time, but I'm pretty sure they will die for this.
Yeah,
Kwepe is just standing in the front line, stacking it up. Yeah, they have to go back to base now.
They gave the first blood. That was really good.
Yeah, this will make the mid lane even harder for the Windranger.
Bottle is already coming for the Zeus now, and Windrunner had to skill Windrunner on level 1. I think she doesn't want to do that against the Zeus.
Also, she did not have a stick, which surprises me when you're expecting a Zeus mid. I think that's the item you go for. Like, there is no circumstance that you don't get it.
The battle begins. Darkseer pulls away. That means a rune for the Zeus, and he bottles the rune. Oh boy. That means full mana for Zeus, and a bounty, and first blood.
This is a lane that's pretty much won. Like,
yeah, it can't get any better.
Even had Kwepe, or Kwep. Kwep. I always call him Kwepe, but he never, you know, I have him in friends list and he never says anything about it. This team, I guess, I'll just keep on calling him Kwepe. You had to, you know, if he didn't agree with it, he had to say it earlier. As they go for Trixie, he's straight away putting in some damage and, well, pretty much not having Surge on level 1 means that he has to run away. And he will already be just taken out of lane for now.
Fairly ballsy against that lane, skipping Surge. I mean, he has to go for the Iron Shell to get some XP in, maybe, but that won't work. And now the lane is pretty much controlled, and he will have a really hard time. But he can always go to the jungle with Iron Shell, so it's fine.
Yeah, the Doom already is pretty much doing the exact same thing. He's just going into the jungle straight away. Like, I'm not even gonna try this. It's just too hard. This does mean that, the save lane is... If they want to, they can push it in fairly early, I would say. You're gonna lose your tier 1 in 5 minutes, most likely. Depending on what their plan is. Trixie's still level 1 with no experience. Walking into the lane now again, but Chilling touches here, and... He does have this triple Iron Shell, but at level 1, it hurts a bit,
but not too much.
A stout shield, man. Procs. They need to get Ricky to hit him.
He still got a Chilling touch debuff. One more hit, the soft cancelled.
Like, is he gonna TP? He can TP, that's stupid. He's gonna hear.
Yeah.
That's 100 gold down. What's 75 gold now? Down the drain. Did give it the kill to Kwepe. I think you prefer to get it on the Ricky, but it's kinda okay-ish. Let's see.
That's Doom. Boots for Vanish, also fine.
He already had boots, he actually started with it.
Oh, he started with boots, yeah.
Yeah. He actually went back to the base first because of the tower hits.
Could see a really fast medallion then. It's also pretty good, pretty decent.
I would like that. That would really just make it just so much harder for them. Also, it helps out the Doom a lot. Getting that aura.
Darkseid decided to go to the jungle now.
Yeah.
There's nothing he can do in the top lane. We got a smoke on Venge. Heading to the mid lane.
For both sides, it means that it opens up the possibility to go more aggressive with the supports. I prefer the Finn stack in that sense, like they have the better supports to go aggressive with the Tusk. Essentially for Germany it's pretty obvious they need to run into it and then use the magic missile to do anything. If they miss on the magic missile, it's pretty much just a wasted gank.
Yeah. Also not quite sure who do I favor in late game, but I think Germany has a pretty strong late game.
Yeah, here we go. Tops Windrun. Does put out some pressure, so that's also something.
It's fine, but I think there was no kill potential at all.
Yeah,
should have maybe aimed to attack jungle instead of smoking their solo. He needed the AA at least. But it's fine.
Yeah.
Press again here. Oh, he's in trouble.
This might be a little bit too aggressive. He gets sharded in as well. But it's just an easy kill there. Like, that was too over aggressive and
nice
they were just ready for it.
Yeah. This gun knew it was coming.
It was a bit too obvious there. What would you favor if it keeps on going like this, Ricky pretty much just free farming into Lycan? Who will in the end will win this? Like at like 50 minutes.
I would say if it goes to super late game, Team Germany should win this because like refresher Zeus, double Doom with refresher Shivas, like you can't fight into this.
Also on mid. Oh, the Shackle Lens as well here on both. He's able to dish out some damage here and with that they're
nice
at least get the return kill. Nemphy pops Windrunner and that means that for Kwepe he needs to take a step back. Luft is also there, but what can he really do? I think he just has to go back to the jungle, yeah.
A Boof offlane is just chill in the jungle.
I think he just denied himself, yeah.
Yeah.
That's fine. But still, he was level, was he? Level 3. Yeah, he's pretty much the same as the Doom. I'm still waiting for when the Lycan says, okay, this is enough, let's take a tower or two. I just up the gold there. Start opening up rushes. And in the middle, again, they go after foe. And they're still on the table. They need some more damage here. And they finally will get it. But this does mean that they will trade the life of Nemphy for it.
That's one a five-man rotation. Yeah. That opens up space for Darks here on the top lane. Just got his level 4 now.
There was maybe a bit of an overcommitment there, going out with someone else. Oh, they just jumped straight into this again. But Valix is not able to connect here with the snowball.
Yeah, nice try there. Could have worked.
Yeah, no harm done, no losses for him, essentially. As support here, they keep on staying in mid here. It's pretty much just on, like, don't touch top, don't touch bottom, and just all go mid.
Yeah. I mean, but you don't want to give Reform to Lycan. Like, he can go out of control pretty fast.
Yeah, if he gets really started on things, that's gonna be so hard. And he almost has his Vladimir's now. They will need to rotate him more than just Kwepe here to stop him.
We have another move in
to the mid again?
Mid lane, yeah.
Also, Valix
he's
looking
for
jungle.
Doom.
Even if he finds him, can he solo kill him? Well, he's fairly low. He might actually get through it.
Cool. He has no Scorch Earth.
There's a chance, but he needs to see him. And
they want to go for Zeus.
They don't see him, yeah. That's the more obvious try here. Lightning Bolt is there. Also, the Tunnacle's Rev comes out. Nicely sharded in here as a moment comes in here to try and turn this one around on Felix, but he's able to get out and the Shackle Shot here just lets him to the tree. Focus Fire is there, Power Shot as well, and they pick up a dual kill here. They will get back Felix here as Kwepe rotates in to kill them off. But still, I would say a pretty big win here again for the Finn stack.
Yeah, for sure. Like, Finn run up is pretty fat already.
And on bots. Ricky got level, well, 7 now and just able to get the kills.
Yeah, but they tried, like, it was a 2-for-2 basically, but they lost bottom tower and Lycan is still on the run. Like, he has another 900 gold already.
What will this be? Is he going for the rush build? You know, get some medallion? Or is he just going for the old school necro build? Or maybe stop on the way for to get his threats? Some options there for him to decide on.
Yeah.
He's just standing still.
I think he should just rush the necro book in this case. They won't get Roshan for free. Like, they have Zeus ult to scout it. Venge can always scout it. Ricky could always be there.
Yeah, he's again found. He's just gonna die here. They're gonna try and get a rotation in and maybe get an MP back here. They're keeping him locked up in the place, but there is gonna be the Shadow Grave coming out. They just try and switch targets for a bit. But doesn't mean that Nemphy is actually able to escape from here. They have a jump in 3 seconds, 1 second. Oh, they're all sharded in. Is he able to get close enough? No, they're not. Are they actually able to get anything back? They get the stun up on Felix, but he gets into the snowball, goes after Kwebe. And they're trying to find him, and they will do that in the end. As no kills have been gotten there.
It was not enough.
It's again
really unfortunate.
That was too much of a rotation in. Yeah, maybe if they stuck a little bit closer to Nemphy there instead of stopping for the 1-2 hits into the desert area, they might have been able to pick him up.
The AA hit traveled really long, but it just hit like 0.5 seconds before the grave expired. It's like really unfortunate.
Well, that's not what you want.
No.
That said, the Wind Ranger has been able to come back pretty nicely here. 4.7k gold up on her. 4.5 on Boogie. I actually wasn't expecting her, of course, being the Wind Ranger, to be actually ahead. In CS,
yeah, after the start Zeus had, but the problem with Zeus is, I mean, the hero itself dishes out tons of damage, but if he gets ganked really early by something like Tusk, there's no way he can escape. He will always die.
And yeah, not having the Dazzle on your team.
Exactly.
That's what you need.
Nothing to save him.
Also, actually good to notice here is that actually at the moment Finstack have been able to get the two towers down on Germany already.
Yeah, they got the top tower while all this chasing in mid.
They're just getting objectives, and this should probably be shown. Yeah, a little bit in net worth, almost 3k. 70.5, okay. So they're ahead in a bit on everything. It's not too big, but...
Oh, Darkseer is in trouble. Surge.
They need more, yeah, there you go. Less jump.
Ricky does so much damage. It's insane.
Yeah, when he has his blink up, he will one moment actually die. Okay, that was almost getting close. Also, his build for going for the max into backstab really helps out.
Yeah. Let's see, AA just got her level 6 from that kill. I mean, that opens up a lot of possibilities. Like, Ricky can just walk around now. If he catches out anyone solo, if the AA blast connects, it's for sure a kill.
Yeah, having if he has a 3 strikes up, I would say so as well. I think if he has 1 or 2, it might be. It depends on the target. Also, Dazzle can just TP out instantly. I think he will be able to maybe barely survive it. If he problem is, he needs to cast Shallow Grave after TPing out. Yeah, hey, Blast comes mid. They find the Dazzle here, but there is no follow up
on
this.
Not going for. They're chasing the Venge.
Kwepe is going to be found here. All is popped. They're running after him. Gets up the magic missile, but what will it do in the end? This is just a bit of a delay.
Yeah, but he got down the Observer Ward, but I'm not sure if he was spotted. He got a really good Observer Ward down there.
They might just think that's here or that he came in for a rotation.
Yep.
It's not. This is not the common place to look at. Dire's top tower is under attack. Are they gonna get this T1 in mid as well? That would be pretty big.
Hey, A-Blast is coming, yeah.
Just his MP. I don't think they can follow this one up. Ricky is just now walking in there.
Hey, A is pretty aggressive on the bot lane. Yeah, he's heading back now.
Yeah. He sees them all going away, and it's like, maybe not say
pushing
that.
AA is not a thing.
It's not the strongest there is in it.
No. I think he found the Darkseer top.
He just TP's out.
He did TP out, yeah.
And not able to
do
it.
That was close.
Almost has a defusal blade here, only about 1100 gold off for the Ricky.
And when you can get this defusal blade in the next 2 or 3 minutes, you will create a lot of pressure. It's like having a Nyx, just a bit better.
Oh, Nephew, okay, we're still able to get the AA Blast here on top of it. They're putting down the nukes here. Will he die from this? It's gonna be close. He's gonna survive. Oh, no. Ricky is shackled, but they don't have vision of him, so he will survive. They do get the Dazzle in the end. That was a beautiful Shallow Grave, though.
But Nemphy playing with fire. Like, that's the second time he just cheats F, basically.
You gotta do that from time to time. Yeah, they know that there is a Tusk here. Kwepe misses on his Wave of Terror here. Are actually going aggressive here now? There's no follow-up for Tusk. Oh, Tusk now is a bit alone here. Ricky is there, but has no real mana.
They're playing Zeus.
They're gonna find him. There is the punch. There we go. AA Blast. Connects as well. There we go. Tusk. Shackle on.
Yeah, not Dust follow-up.
They need to start carrying some more dust. The only one who has any kind of detection is the Dazzle. With all the meanwhile, the Lycan is just free farming away. Went for his Necroboot, level 1 has it now.
Yeah, he just skipped the medallion. I think that was smart. He knows that he can't do Roche, and he would just straight up go for Necro 3, and then he has detection for Ricky.
Yeah, that will definitely help out his team. And you can even do rush with Necrobook, it's just better with Medallion. That's some fingers to it in the end.
They're doing a big stack now.
Oh, are they going to
be nice swap?
But that doesn't matter too much if you get the Shackle follow-up like this. This is gonna cost the life of Kwepe, and they get the dust out now on the Ricky. They need to start running away. But Lycan is already following this run up, running after them. They're not able to dish out the DPS to just force them back here. They just keep on following, and there's nothing they really can do with the AA Blast already put out. The power shot is gonna hit there. Luft now finally comes in, but has no mana to pop down the Doom here on top of someone.
And he mana burned him immediately with the Necrobook. That was a bit of a plan.
Oh, they find Zeus. He's gonna be punchy to the air. No, he's not. Dazzle picks up the kill. Are they just gonna keep on going aggressive here, or are they gonna opt to go for a rush or something else?
And they went straight ahead into the Roche pit, and there's not much Team Germany can do about it. I mean, AA Blast is...
They need the mana. Zeus is back
at
18.
They have AA Blast now, it's flying in, but there is no follow-up.
Yeah, they need the Zeus for this, to do anything. Pepe is nearby. He can throw in like a Wave of Terror, but it won't really kill anybody. They get out of defensive, we looped. He's now walking. It's still just 2 versus 5. If they get jumped now, they will actually lose before they can do anything.
Well, there's 0 mana on Dazzle.
Yeah, that's
continue.
Zeus is now also back, so they will go back. Leave it for now. Ricky will scout out how low Roshan is, which is about 25% left.
Think about doing it with Wave of Terror. I'm not sure if it's possible. They need someone to tank. If someone
did he see this Darkseid Iron Shell Kwepe? Yeah. Oh, he did follow it, of course, here with the Tusk. Tusk is even able to evade the AA Blast here. Does it mean that they can get a nice fight here for the side of the Finstack? Doom comes out on Nemphy, and there comes the Thunderstrike. They're able to at least kill off the Dazzle for now, but the ultimate is popped by
no
Boogie.
Detection.
No level 3 Necrobook just yet. It's still level 1.
Oh, he got the courier.
Oh, that's a big one. That's a big snipe. They will get Luft in the end, but... This was a courier with... What is this? Like 3.2k gold on it. That's a big steal. As they are at least able to find AA as well.
They have a sentry. Yeah, they have a sentry down there. Just a bit too late.
I tried it, I guess. It's... It's something.
Yeah, now they have Roshan. Might just go and push in with when a chicken respawns.
Yeah, I think that's now the timing for them.
Yeah,
it's not so that's not the usual thing. Like, it's not like, hey, we're waiting for Roshan, we're waiting for Kudos now, we're waiting for a donkey.
No.
It's an actual donkey. They have the normal one.
Let's see if Zeus is going for 4 stuff now. Like, he really needs something to hit the eyes.
2.1k. I think it's, yeah, if you go for so much gold, isn't it gonna be a blink dagger? For four step, you tend to already buy like your components.
Yeah, that's true, but I think blink dagger won't solve his problem.
If he gets jumps, it's the problem he does do it.
Ice shards are just flying around, and if anything hits you or a power shot, your dagger is disabled, and then this guy will just snowball on you. That's it.
Yeah, let's see, they have level 3 vacuum as well, which has a pretty big range. You have iron shells on wolves, so if this guy were dead like they did before with on Kwepe, it means that you can't blink out anymore either, so you're gonna be stuck. Yeah. I would prefer T4 stuff as well. Also, you're just able to save your teammates. But maybe he thinks, you know, I got a vengeful behind.
But he got his dagger now.
Yeah. Maybe
hopefully it will happen.
They got fenged, so maybe he can get swapped back and then, you know, take some steps, guide a bit, and then blink. But it's so far, it's gonna be hard. They're not really putting on the pressure that you want them to.
Yeah. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. I mean, we have now a 5k net worth lead on the side of Finstack, but I think Team Germany is still fine. I mean, they have AA Midas with like 1.1k. They have the dagger now on Zeus, he's not food anymore. And we have the Midas on the Doom. I think they are doing pretty fine.
They're trying to do some split pushing here though, but that doesn't work out at all. Is it just gonna most likely lose this tower? Oh, Boogie, yes, pop his ultimate and start running away fairly soon now. Hey, ultimate connects. Is his team able to follow up on this? So far, only the Tusk has been able to rotate inwards as Boogie gets low and gets killed. They had to pop every
the
ultimate dead.
Aegis is popped and the ultimate is gone. But they have no follow-up.
Yeah, there's no more ultimates left on the side of the Germany either. So it's hard to do anything as there's gonna be the swap Kwepe sacrificing his life there for his core. That's the support life.
Yeah. Lost the right call here.
Ricky just barely outside of the dust range there.
You're going for the deny. No way.
That's too dangerous. Oh, what Luft? He's still there. Okay, they didn't.
Hey,
mind.
He might have the creep. The greed.
Yeah, okay, so yeah, they have actually real greed. Actually, apart just from that Midas, they have the actual Midas. Now they have a blink, so they're not really in fighting shape. It's
no,
them down
not.
For 40 seconds. They're gonna lose this tier 2 as well. There's no Doom, no Tunica's Wrath. Like, there's nothing they can really do against this.
Yeah, Shapeshift comes up in 25 seconds, and they have still a mag. They would just take this tower for free.
They're trying to contest this, but they can't jump in. Like,
yeah,
A blast. Yeah, that misses. They should know now that they have time.
Yeah, now they can go.
They have to at least 30 seconds now to do whatever they want and get out. Doesn't mean they have to commit.
Ultimates come up fairly soon. In 20 seconds for Doom, 5 seconds for Thunder God's Wrath. Well, the tornado. They're pinging it out though.
Yeah. Oh, Doom. Yeah, he's found. Are they gonna jump him right now? Did I vision?
Cool.
No, he blinks out. Smokescreen as well stops him from going in there. The dust a little bit too easy. And Zinxis doesn't really fall for that essay. We'll pick up the tier 2 here now.
They got what they want. And the chicken is back and now the necrophree is live for...
For like a plus 3k like gold. Is he going AC? Maybe Basher if he wants to fight. BKB is also an option though.
BKB would help a lot. Like, not going for BKB here would be... big problem because the Ricky smoke still gives like so much miss, and if you have BKB you just negate it completely and just fight straight into the cloud into Ricky and you will die.
Yeah, you just need to be accepted that one of you that you might be doomed, but yeah, like before, you just need to get up before. Oh, Valix, yeah, they hit him with the AA blast here. They do get off another nice yellow grave here. They're gonna go after Luft. Are they able to kill him off here before the Tusk falls down? No, they are not. And it will be a 1-for-1 trade, but still in favor of Finstack here. Now Trixie surges forward. Doesn't really have anything else apart from the surge to get close to people. He tries to get a vacuum off, but in the end he only cuts down some trees.
Yeah. I think they couldn't fight there. You should just sit back and farm. I mean, they traded. I mean, any trade is good if you when you're 10k behind, but... That might open Rex now because they have no Doom.
Yeah,
if Doom respawns, he has no Doom.
This AA Blast is gonna hit too though. But again, there is no real follow-up at the moment. Ricky will come in. Boogie is getting low. They need a bit more swap aggressively here.
There is gonna be the Shadow Griff coming out. He pops a Necron Book. Is he able to escape from this? The tower hit will kill him actually here in the end. As the Necronomicons are going after the Ricky one for one trade right now. Zeus is not able to follow them. Necrobooks are retreating. Luft goes in here, but he gets shackled up into the tree. And this might have been a big mistake for him as Nemphy now gets another kill.
And that's the problem, like you respawn with a Doombringer and you just use Doom before at the tier 1 mid. You're pretty much useless, and if you blink in aggressive, I mean, what? You can't achieve anything.
There are also so many defensive items around with Glimmer Capes and stuff. It's they can't really get through the fin stack here. This is... I already lost the first Rex. I think it was just
a range Rex. It's fine.
It's range, yeah.
AA is really close to Axe, though. I could turn that to favor because at the moment they hit someone with AA Blast.
Hey, I think AA made a little bit of a misclick.
Where?
Well, in his skill points, essentially his level 11 is 11 points and he doesn't have a level 2 into his ultimate.
Oh, yeah.
That's a mistake there. I think he knows it himself as well. Might have leveled up in the middle of a team fight.
Yeah, probably.
But
he will be level 12 soon.
Oh, they're going in here. Look, that's the dude poops on Nemphy, but he already gets force left out and runner zone. You need to get some more follow up on top of him, and they will in the end.
That's big, actually. That's really big.
This is two kills. This is really, really good here for the German sec. This is
and
what they needed to.
They will follow it up with a tower immediately. And in the meantime, AA is just farming freely on the top lane, and he will close like 500 gold to Ganem Scepter. When he hits his axe, that's huge, because at the moment, when the Ice Blast connects, people just run out, they get graved, and they get healed up. But when he gets axed, the debuff duration of the AA is so long.
AA is gonna die here.
But no.
He's gonna try and TP out, but that has like no.
Away from his
oh my god. That sucks so hard.
Yeah, he wanted the last hit. That's really unfortunate.
He's really slapping his face right now, like, no! Why? And the Lycan gets his heart. He just wants raw HP here against all the damage coming out from the German side. And they get the courier snipe on the other side here. Okay, what was on there? So clicking the radiant side as Windranger gets off a kill here. That's actually a 4 step for Kwepe. That's another 2200 gold down the drain. But Alex, she's Luft. Ah, Luft has a
like it's just split pushing top. Not much they can do about it. AA is not alive. Yeah,
they need people to help it out, but they're trying to man fight him, but this is not working out at all as the dust comes in and they pick up the Ricky. AA Blast is coming through. Boogie, is he able to dodge this one? No, he's not, but he does get off his ultimate and will start running after them. Kwepe, are they gonna get off some right clicks here? We'll start hitting him. Nice vacuum wall on three here. They're gonna get the kill on Kwepe somewhere down line. There they go. There they will. They get a double kill here as Zeus has been forced to blink back. They don't have the tower yet though, and they did lose their tusk for it. Another buyback by the AA as well, but AA doesn't have an ultimate just yet, so there's not a whole lot he can do to help them out.
And Matt is dying to neutral creeps.
Yeah, this one is going down, for sure. Just having these wolves will do a trick, but Boogie just makes sure of it. He's just going for top lane now. Having his heart just regens him up so much in between.
Yeah,
these
it's insane. He sits at 3.2k HP, I mean, how are you gonna kill him?
We got 140 regeneration, that's not something to love at. They need to hit the AA Blast to just stop that.
Yeah, I mean you could see how good Necrobook is in this game. Like Doom is staggering in and they immediately mana burn him. He can't get off his Doom because his mana pool is so low.
Yeah, going for the blink first with Midas doesn't help it at all. None of his items increases his stats as
for Shiva's lava.
Yeah, this is gonna be too late as he's just gonna die here. He gets the swap off, but that will just mean that Kwepe also dies.
Two people there.
And with two people down, I don't think they can fight this anymore. They do have a buyback on the Doom, but they're gonna lose their tower before he even gets close to the fight. They get off a smoke screen, that might actually prolong it long enough. Yeah, the mission is pretty big here. But still they lose the tower in the end.
But they have to sustain, like, just wait for next wave, go again.
15 seconds on Necrobook, that might be a little bit of a problem. Do they have any sentries? Do they have a dust? I think that's about all. Where's the Dazzle when you need him? There you go. Okay, Dazzle has some sentries as well. And the body gem. Yeah, they're gonna end this one now.
They try. They can try, but I mean, they can still take a really bad fight.
Yeah, they could also go for Roshan, but I think they feel pretty confident at the moment. Yeah, more than 50k ahead, 10k experience. These AI bests are not hitting on and connecting, so he still doesn't have his axe.
No.
This man, he might not even be able to get it before the end. I don't know.
Could sell his Midas. Would be pretty good. That Midas get axe.
That means that you're all in on this fight.
Yeah,
if you don't win,
they have to all in.
Right now they have to do something against Boogie, because he's gonna get this. He gets off his ultimate before, and look at this Nemphy. Got the BKB, pops it up. He gets no damage from everything that pretty much is threw on him. Doomball in the end, of course, we are down, but the AA Blast connects on three here.
Four.
Not three, Nemphy was just outside of the range there. Yeah. Dazzle will pay with his life here, as well as the Tusk. Phalanx goes down, Trixie is now in the back. They're gonna go after him, Quepa goes aggressively. It is not able to kill him down, but Zinxis does come in here. Oh, Nemphy.
They hold.
They have a big hold here. They just lose to melee. Lycan is able to escape. As there's a little bit of a break here, but that was a big fight there coming out from the side of Germany.
Yeah. I mean, if Doom gets off a good Doom, I mean, if he can dagger in with mana and he just dooms the Windrunner, a lot of damage is gone. And they can take the fight, actually. Like, Germany is not out yet.
They did have to pay with one melee Rex there again.
No, it was the range. It was only a range.
Range? I thought they focused on the melee. Never mind, they got the range.
It's really good.
But how will they in the end deal with all these waves pushing in? Like, that's the problem. Even though it's just a ranged Rex, does mean that the wave is pushing in more and more, and they don't really have the best of creep clear. Like, Ricky is
their wave clear is bad, and they have to deal with the split push, but if you have Axe on AA now, I mean, you can't just walk there, because Doom will close in on Shivas, and he will just dagger on you, Doom you, Shivas you, and if the Ice Blast connects, you're dead if you're split pushing top. Even Lycan will die to that. So, they're in pretty good shape now.
Well, they will need to contest the next rush, and if they're not able to do that, then it will be a problem.
Aegis on Windrunner will be a problem.
Like, that's like the hero that's gonna go on for sure. Like, Boogie will just pop his ultimate, run into the base. And then if you doom him, pop everything on him, then you have a Wind Ranger to deal with who has an axe and a BKB. And then Aegis, now, then you can't kill her anymore.
Windrunner actually has no damage at all. Don't forget, like, even if she focus fires something, like, she has no Daedalus, no Maelstrom, it's literally just BKB, Axe, and a Blink Dagger.
Yeah, at the same time, it's not like they have a lot of HP on the side of Germany.
That's true.
The best is Ricky, because just purely on base on his armor, like, his 23 armor, he's fairly tanky to physical damage.
And Doom is also tanking up slowly, like, he will have Shivas now.
That's nicely. I saw the buff actually with the attack speed is actually really good for the creeps. That will slow down pretty extensively, but still, I'm a bit fearful. Like, you just have to lose one fight for the side of Finland and for Germany, and you're just completely out of it. Like,
the next mistake from Team Germany is game, but they can sim again.
Yeah, they know rush is going on. They have vision of them walking in there. Rixie's running
around.
Cube
comes
here
from behind. Ice Blast is.
It's gonna come.
Nowhere?
No, he had the TP out, and because of that, it just completely went over it. Nemphy comes in now as well. Cleared up a spot. They can't contest it now anymore with
no,
Blast missing.
That was unfortunate.
Nemphy will get the last hit, will get the Aegis, and. Yeah. Weppe is still here. Does he have. Yeah, he's waiting for his TP to cool down.
He's on a journey.
I think he's even himself is wondering, where am I exactly going to?
Yeah. He's like, okay guys, I'm there.
I'm close. TP's back to base, we'll be there.
Yeah, so that's another push in the top lane. I mean, the Finstack, they can literally just frontline Windrunner now and just focus fire down the racks.
Yeah, that's essentially one of, like, they have two options, either throw in minions or use Nemphy.
And here we go. He would just stand in front.
Oh, they go for Trixie, that one? Okay, they want to get him out, but there's going to be the nice snowball, and they pretty much dodge everything here. As they will get no kills with this Stunts Got Wrath, actually. They're all just living through it. Trixie is not dying from the Doom here. As they need to start running away with the Ricky as well as Zeus. Force staff out, but they still get followed by the Economicus for a bit. He can't kill off this range, that will, or this melee, that will mean he's dead as Nemphy just goes aggressively. Windrun kills him. Three down, this is gonna be the end.
Yeah.
They get Ricky here as well eventually. They just leave him there a little bit. He got, oh, he got actually off the perch, so he will survive.
That's why you banned Tusk. That snowball just completely turned the fight. It saved like two people from the AA blast.
Well, take away some tick damage from the Doom and everything that comes around it. Okay, we'll see what will be the play here. It's a Ricky and now a Vengeful against, well, pretty much any 5-man lineup. It's not gonna win out. Oh, this though, this is really nice on the Darkseer. I do need to say Darkseer messed up his Force Staff and Force Staff himself further into the base.
The mana Force Staff into the base.
Felix, will he die here before the end? No, there is a nice Shallow Grave helping his team.
Well,
so that was the first game here coming out for Finstack. Yeah, they just really did what their lineup was supposed to do, and they were able to get back pretty nicely from this, from the first rotation or the first kill on to the Zeus. Or the Zeus, actually.
Yeah.
There's not a whole lot to say about it. It just really just did what they had to do and just played pretty well.
Just snowball on the Zeus all day long.
Yeah.
Win mid lane. From there you go.
Yeah, from there on Zeus kind of felt out of it. Got a blink dagger, but yeah, blink dagger in the end didn't help him too much, sadly. Went back for the four staff.
Yeah, after.
But you have no damage in the end. Ricky falls off quite a bit once you see him and he can't fight anymore.
If they have a bit better early to mid game with the two Midas and they don't die so much and just defend their towers and try to farm in safety, they could have pulled it off.
Yeah, that's true, but in the end, it's the Finstack victory here in the first game of this best of three in the National Pro Dota Cup here. This is the loser bracket, the loser of the next game, if it's Germany, is going to be out. If they win it, we'll have a best of three full on our hands here. With me co-casting today is at LairGG, and well, I am Sander. You can follow me at Sander_Dota, and we'll see you all for the second game.